Welcome back to the channel, everyone. It's been probably another week or two, I think, since the last video. Hopefully it'll be a bit quicker than a week or two for the uploads whenever I get around to doing them. It's currently the 23rd of December, so two days away from Christmas, and I am back on the way to On a Mission headquarters to have a look at the Civic, because today is a very important day. The engine's going in. So there's been a couple of updates that have happened since last time to this time, as in a couple of parts that I've thought about buying. I've wanted these parts for, well, ever since I wanted to do a kswap, but they're not essential to the build. And they're quite expensive, but they are literally sort of the cherry on top type of pieces for the engine. It'll make it run better. It'll give it the most power it can have with the current setup. So I'll tell you those and show you some of those when I get to On a Mission headquarters. I'm going to get on the way now, but I did just want to give a massive thank you so far to Dale and Amy, who run and own On a Mission. Obviously, anyone who's been watching the videos knows that they've taken the job on. They are usually EP3 and FN2 and just DC5 general breaker, but they are wanting to get into builds. They do sponsor quite a few race drivers that do sort of 750 motor club championships, Type R trophy, stuff like that. So they do a couple of different things, but they are wanting to get into builds as well. And obviously my build being pretty much a full shell ground up resto with all brand new high quality parts was sort of a good example for them to do. I just want to give a massive thank you to both of those, because the amount of work that's gone on to the car already is just phenomenal. It looks incredible. It looks far better than I ever thought it could do. They've both done an amazing job. Very knowledgeable. There's certain parts that they've questioned me about. For example, the rocker cover baffle. I never knew such thing could be a problem. So there's loads of different things like this that, thanks to their expertise and knowledge, they've been able to advise me and basically help the build along the way for things that I didn't even know existed. I just want to give a big thank you to both of them. Amy and Dale, thank you very much. And anyone that's thinking about having their car built, repaired in any way, just parts, speak to On a Mission. They've got loads of things in stock. They refurb loads of parts. If you see all of the parts they've got, they refurb subframes, low control arms. They've got so much stuff there, loads of expertise. Speak to On a Mission if you need anything for your Honda. On a Mission, Dale and Amy's unit. You would have seen in the last part of the video was the engine going in. There's been quite a lot of updates and progress since that point. I think it's been about two or three weeks. I've just got in, I haven't stopped smiling. The car looks incredible. It just, Dale sorted the alignment out on the back, just on a, you know, because it was quite cambered in. The way the car is sitting right now is just, oh my days, it is. It's amazing. I'm so happy with it right now. It looks amazing. And the engine bay is just next level. I've come over because I've got some more parts to bring over. So I'll just show you those quickly. So we've got some power steering fluid, Honda power steering fluid in there from Torque GT. So we've got this, which is from America by a company called CBC. It's basically a 3D printed bracket to allow for the DC5 K-Pro ECU to mount to the EK chassis without making a bracket or drill in anywhere or anything like that. So yeah, it's a 3D printed bracket for the ECU. And then we've got these, which are Muteki HR38 wheel nuts, which I've been waiting for from Japan, ordered via Torque GT for 3 months, 4 months. And basically I wanted these specific ones to go with the blue ring on the Advance. Obviously I've got the Enki valve covers, but to go with the blue ring on the Advance, I thought these blue ring wheel nuts would just look very nice. So these are HR38s, hopefully that's focusing. HR38 wheel nuts with a blue ring on. So these should in theory look very nice on the wheel when they're all on. So that's something else that we've brought over. And we've got some other things as well. Dale made me aware that the centre bore on the wheels need a spigot ring. So we've ordered some spigot rings for that. And also for the power steering line, we needed an adapter to go from AN6 to AN8, I believe, which we've now got here as well. So those are the parts that I've brought over today. Yeah, some parts I've been waiting quite a long time for. And some of the final parts ready for the build. Dale and Amy are now onto the sort of final niggly bits of the build, getting things to line up, figuring out how lines are going to fit, and basically getting it ready for to go to the exhaust shop to have a 3-inch exhaust fabbed up, along with the manifold that I've got, the collector on that widening from 2.5 to 3-inch. So that's something that's got to be done. It's basically getting all of the final bits now ready to be able to turn the key to try and start the car. So I'm just going to turn the camera around and show you some of the progress that's been done, because as I say, the car is looking amazing. It's just wow. Just I'm over the moon with it. So yeah, let me show you. So we now have the engine in, as you saw in the previous part. However, we now have the Skunk 2 Ultra inlet manifold, Skunk 2 throttle body. We've got all of our hybrid racing coil pack cover, engine oil cap cover, we've got our dipstick. We have our K-tuned upper coolant housing, we've got hybrid racing fuel rail, but we also have the tucked K-swap harness. So what this allows for is, as you can see here, as you can see there, the engine harness is in, but you can't see any injector wires coming out. And along with that, we went for the hybrid racing tuck fuel kit. So you've now not got basically a fuel line that's running all the way around, something like that. It comes out in the middle. So that goes underneath the inlet, nice and hidden. And then you've just got this one here, which, because I wanted this upper coolant housing, we had to buy an extender. So the fuel line would basically reach to the fuel pressure reg on the side. So we've had that done. We've got the hybrid racing intake. So you can see the hybrid racing intake runs underneath the chassis rail. Dale started to fit the oil cooler and the oil cooler lines. So these big lines here are effectively what run to the oil cooler. And down there, you can see where the oil cooler is mounted and where the lines go to. So they all follow, basically all follow through there and go to the back of the engine. We've also got the hard race strut brace on. We've got our 1-inch servo there. We've got our S2000 res and firewall bracket. And now I'll get on to what was the saga of the power steering. So I wanted to run power steering on this car. I don't want a looped rack. I've not bought a DC2 subframe and rack to have a looped line, basically. I want a nice short ratio. And I want it to be nice and easy to drive. I want it to be a livable car to drive. I wanted to run power steering, so I spent all the money on the hybrid racing power steering kit. Great. And then I realized that the OEM DC5 pump, the pulley on that, can hit the bottom of the bonnet. So I dealt with CPL Racing to get the reduced pulley, which is like a copy of a Jackson Racing pulley. That apparently allows you to not cut the inner skin. That's wrong. It still hit the inner skin. So the only other method for us to go then was to buy a K-tuned power steering relocation bracket for 290 quid. So more money into this power steering saga. That basically puts the power steering right at the bottom of the engine there. You can see the pump. I'm going to paint the pump, but yeah, you can see the power steering pump down there, along with the reduced size pulley, and you can see the lines coming off that. But what that then meant is that, if anyone remembers, I bought a really nice full width hybrid racing radiator because I love how they look. What that meant is that it collided with the pump down there, so we had to go for a half width radiator in the end. Massive thank you to Talk GT for replacing and exchanging the radiator after me owning it for a year sat in a box, because that would have been an absolute nightmare. So yeah, we've managed to get the half width rad in there, which obviously fits a lot better and clears everything now, which is good. And something else I don't actually think I've mentioned on the car, anyone that followed the build previously, you would have seen that I purchased some Advan RG1s from Hong Kong, from DB8 Motorsport, I think the company was. 205/45/16 Yokohama Advan AD08 RS tyres I've got on the Advans. So we've got Advan on top of Advan, love it. And these just look, oh my God, just like I say, now Dale sorted the alignment out on the back, I'm so glad that I did research on wheel specs, because they just fit amazing. I don't want to touch the rear arches on this car because they're absolutely mint. So I wanted a wheel that can, you know, be lowered enough and not have to worry about hitting the arches or anything. And oh my days, doesn't it look amazing? I mean, look at that. Look at the way it's sitting. I mean, I don't think you can ask for a better fitment. That is just, oh my days, absolutely beautiful. So yeah, so obviously it's not been aligned yet. So, you know, it's more of an eye alignment, as Dale calls it. But yeah, it looks amazing. So once it's had a proper alignment on it, it's going to look really good. The fronts are still quite in terms of the camber. So they I'm sure they'll come out slightly. I mean, just look at it. It just looks really good on these. The gold on the red looks really, really good. And obviously that is what informed the decision on the rocker cover. So Dale took one of the wheels to the paint shop he uses to have it matched as close as possible. We couldn't get an exact match, but you know, pretty close match when you look at it like that. Obviously the light is pointing on the rocker cover at the moment, but yeah, it's just look at it, man. Like, it looks amazing. Got the SIR front grille on now, and I can see over here that the Type R lip that I've got, that's obviously been out. So I think that'll be fitted at some point soon. But yeah, man, just look at it. It looks so good at the minute. So there's something else to add that I haven't shown you yet. Another part that I've probably had for over 2 years now. I'm amazed at how much in price these shifters have gone up. They've gone up, they've nearly like doubled in price over the last 2 years. So I'm so glad I managed to get it when I did. But yeah, let me show you the inside now. So in here now, we now have the Acuity four-way shifter mounted, along with the Acuity base plate. And it's also a manual car now. Dale has changed it from an auto to a manual. We have three pedals, and we now have an incredible shifter. God dang. And down there, you can see the Caper ECU and all of the harness that's being mated to it. And I'll just hopefully be able to make you hear I mean, come on. And obviously the car now has a rear disc swap on it as well now, which Dale has painted. So 262s on the back, 282s on the front. However, I do want spoon calipers. In here, we've got all of the fluids. So we've got our coolant, Honda coolant. We've got our gearbox oil, Honda gearbox oil, and Miller's engine oil. Oh, and also brake fluid as well, plus the power steering fluid that I've brought over. So hopefully we've got all the fluids now. Something to add is the engine has had every single seal replaced. So that was something that I've been collecting over the time. But yeah, every single seal on the engine has been replaced. We've got an FD2 crank pulley. We've got a new water pump. We've got some T7 design blanking plates. T7 design, oil cooler blanking plate and water pump sort of feed blanking plates. Then that allows for the external oil cooler to go on. So we've done that. We've got the idler pulley, which is a new released item from on a mission that's on there now, which I'll show you. So you can see that there, all been vapor blasted, and I believe a zinc plated pulley, which yeah just finishes off the top of the engine really nice. So I've just got done it on a mission, checking out a couple of things Dale and Amy wanted me to see, dropping off some parts, things like that. I'm blown away. Every time I come here, I have a great time for one, but two, seeing the updates on the car in the flesh is just another level. The car is absolutely amazing. Seeing it today, I walked in there, I was setting up camera gear and just walking around, speaking to a couple of customers that they had in there whilst they were running around getting bits and whatnot. Yeah, and I just noticed when I was setting up my camera gear and whatnot, I turned around, looked at the engine bay and just thought, wow. And I just couldn't get the smile off my face. It was, the engine bay looks amazing. Everything I dreamed of and everything like that is in that car. The shifter's amazing, the engine bay is amazing, all the parts, the wheels look amazing, the way the wheels are sitting. Dale sorted out did an eye alignment on the front as well today. And the way the wheels are sitting, I'll put in a picture that I took, they are completely flush. The fitment on those wheels and the size and the specs of those wheels are perfect for an EK on a DC2 rear trailing arm. They fit amazing. The tyres fit amazing. Everything on that car at the moment is just looking great. Obviously, it wants some paint at some point. Obviously, it's still Milano red, but the way some of the bumpers have been blended in and stuff, you know, they've not done a great job on some of the paint. Whoever did the paint before, I guess it was just done cheaply by the previous owner, maybe a, you know, cheap body shop or something, I don't know. But yeah, the paintwork's not great on the front and rear bumpers and one of the wings. So eventually I want to get the whole car resprayed effectively, the same as the engine bay. And that'll go with the EK9 preface bumper as well. So none of the bump strips. And I've got a facelift rear bumper from Justin, who's Captain's Vlog on YouTube. And on the inside, I want to have some bride recliner seats or Recaro recliner seats. Not the standard EK9 and DC2 seats. I've had those time and time over again. So I want something different now. Plus, for how much they're going for at the moment, I might as well get something different. But then the inside, I want to basically have all of the sort of, you know, the A-pillars, I think they're called, just by the front windscreen and the headlining and everything like that, done in like a suede or an Alcantara. So that makes the inside look really nice rather than the, you know, the cheap plastic that Honda did in the 90s. So that'll make that look really nice, you know, get a JDM center console so I can have a 7-inch touchscreen or something in there. Just modernise the internals a bit. Like I say, I'm amazed by the car at the moment. It's looking fantastic. I think we're going to be relatively close soon to starting it. We're just doing a couple of the niggly bits at the moment, as I was saying earlier. Coolant expansion tanks and stuff like that, trying to figure out where to route things. But yeah, a massive thank you to Dale and Amy on a mission. Doing an amazing job, recommending some great things that I never would have known before or solutions to problems we've got. So yeah, they're very, very knowledgeable. Anyone who's wanting their car built or for anyone who wants any refurbished parts or anything like that, send a message to Swan Emission because they have so many parts. They refurbish so many parts. They have parts made. I think they've just released their springs and retainers for obviously the K20 engines. So yeah, they're bringing out some amazing parts. So for anyone who's wanted anything like that, get in touch with Swan Emission. Doing a great job on my car and I couldn't be happier at the moment. So I think I'll sign this one out here. This will probably be episode 3, I think it'll be. Probably be a bit of a longer one because I've merged together 2 or 3 visits to the car. So yeah, so I think the next episode could be the car starting. Maybe not, maybe yes, don't know. But yeah, we'll catch up with you next time. Thank you for watching. Peace.